What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Pens and Tea. My name is Carrie, and today I'm playing with something I have never done before. My desk is an absolute disaster zone. It is just after Christmas, and I have not put anything away yet. But I bought this low-temperature hot glue gun from Amazon, and I'm testing out doing wax seals with them. I've never done one before, so I thought I would give it a whirl and bring you guys along for me. I've literally done one. So far, the biggest problem I've seen is that it kind of gets stuck at the tip, which is a little bit of an issue. But I do like that it is like super controlled as far as like where the like hot glue goes. You can really control like how much that you want on it, which is super, super cool, so that you don't end up wasting as much wax. Now, granted, I like mine to be big, and this looks pretty much like a perfect seal. And they're coming out relatively uniform. Literally, these are the only two that I've ever done using this hot glue gun. But I thought I would throw a quickie video up for you just to show you. I bought these sticks off of Amazon as well. Some gold and red ones. Come on, camera, you can focus. They're kind of expensive, but not too bad. These aren't supple wax though, so I'm sure that they're not going to go through the mail super well, but I thought for a first time try, I just wanted to see what it would turn out like. I usually do the spoon method, which I will put a link into my description here. It's actually the most popular video on my channel. I usually do the spoon method, where, you know, I just melt it over, like a candle or something. And then after that, I'll kind of like drip it out of the spoon. That's nice when I am, you know, just doing like one seal or a couple seals. This I can see being really, really handy if you're doing a lot. So I kind of wish I had this just before Christmas, when I was doing all of my seals for my Christmas cards, which I hand deliver. So it wouldn't matter that the wax is more brittle wax, because then literally I think I did like 20 seals, and this would get that done super, super quick. I totally just dropped the camera, which is why this got all weird. The only thing that I miss about the spoon over this, the only drawback that I see so far, is if you want to do any kind of like wax mixing, like to mix colors or whatever, that might be a little bit more difficult to do with this, because you are locked into whatever like stick you have, versus like being able to put in like little bits and pieces. Once I get a little bit more comfortable with this, I think I might try, you can just kind of like whap that off. I think I might try to like maybe cut up really, really small pieces of wax. Like I now have these wax beads. I might try and like cut off like little tiny pieces and drop them in this wax while it's still hot, and then stamp it and see what that turns out to be like. But I would have to get a new tripod in order to do that, because I would definitely need both hands. So guys, that's it for this very quick look video here. I hope you liked it. If you did, hit that subscribe button and that thumbs up button. New videos come out every Monday and Friday. And as always, I'll see you next time. And I will come out with another wax video once I've done further testing with this. I'll tell you which one I prefer. Guys, I'll see you next time. Bye. think this is gonna be too thick. I don't know, we'll find out. I'm pressing down really hard because I think that second piece was a little too thick. I'll have to cut them, almost like shave them instead of cut them. And it kind of still worked though. But yeah, so this one up here was much thinner. I like the look of that better. So this one was thicker. So there you go. Just gotta shave them.